students, I hope all of you are fit and fine. We have completed the text of Achilles by Gerald Malcolm Turrell, and today, as I promised you, I am going to provide the and also discuss the answers of almost all the questions provided in your book. A few questions are left for you. You have to solve those questions, write the answers of those questions on your own, and I will check them in the examination copy, because when I will reveal which questions have been left for you to do, you will easily understand that those are, you know, direct questions. You can just go through the chapter. You should go through the chapter very minutely and thoroughly, and you can just copy the things from the text to answer those questions. Okay, almost copy. So at first, wait, let me open my copy. Okay, first one. Okay, there are the questions like, where did the narrator first meet the rose petal man? Explain the meaning of the phrase fairy tale air. How do we know that? Okay, this one I'm explaining, but the place, the phrase fairy tale air, fairy tale air, this has been discussed quite a few times in the live class. Okay, so I have just provided the same answer. Go through them, you will easily understand the first one and the second one. Third one, how do we know that the rose petal man cared well for his pets? We know that the rose petal man cared well for his pets by the way he had maintained half a dozen tortoises, polished their shells with oil, and decorated their front legs with little red bows. Next one. What made the narrator select one particular tortoise from among the rest? Again, an answer that doesn't, you know, that I just don't need to explain this, because I have mentioned only the things that have been mentioned in your text. There is nothing new, nothing to add, just the things, just the information mentioned in your text. So go through the answer, you will easily understand it if you have gone through the text even once, okay, and followed the classes, video class and live class. How were Roger and Achilles rivals? How? Obviously, both loved the same thing, grapes. That's why. Why did Achilles find Roger irritating? Achilles found Roger irritating because he would always vigorously lick the grape juice that Achilles had dribbled on himself. Anyway, now come to the exercise. Question number 2A. I have provided the answer, though I should not have, but I am not mentioning that here because it is a direct question again. Second, okay, what were they doing? This is like they were trying to negotiate the price for the tortoise, obviously. 2B, why were they not having a verbal conversation? Because the narrator realized that the rose petal man, he could not speak. That's why they had to communicate through gestures. Okay. What was the result of their interaction? As a result of their interaction, the rose petal man agreed to reduce the price of the tortoise to half. Okay, like 50%. From 10 to 5. Okay, 5 instead of 10. Now question number 3. How did the narrator know that Achilles liked this fruit the best? From the quotation, but that the fruit that Achilles liked best was wild strawberries. How did the narrator know that? Because Achilles would become hysterical at the mere sight of wild strawberries, obviously from this fact. Next, how did Achilles eat his fruit, both the small and big ones? Again, this has been taken, the words had been taken, the information has been taken only from the text. I have not added anything. There is nothing to add. Okay, let's go through the answer. Question number 3C. What would Roger do to Achilles after he was fed? After Achilles was fed, Roger would vigorously lick the juice Achilles had dribbled upon himself. You can mention that he would creep to Achilles and then he did this particular thing that I have mentioned. Question number 5, the dress, describe how the hospital man was dressed. I have not provided this answer because I should not. This answer in full details has been mentioned in the text itself. So go through the text thoroughly and minutely, as I always say, and you can easily answer this question. Okay, easily answer this question. How did the narrator react when he realized that, wait a second. Okay, how did the narrator react when he realized that the rose petal man could not speak? What does this tell you about the narrator? Okay, when the narrator realized that the rose petal man could not speak, he started communicating with him through gestures. This shows that the narrator was very perceptive, sensitive and understanding. Okay, now what is perceptive? If you join the two things like understanding and being sensitive, the person obviously becomes perceptive. Okay, this is nothing new. Alright? Obviously, if you understand someone's situation or someone's problem or whatever you say, only then you can, you know, be good to him or her. The narrator was not like, oh, he cannot speak like me, so just who would put so much effort to communicate with him? So let's avoid it. No, he was really understanding and sensitive and perceptive. That's why even after realizing that rose petal man could not speak, was unable to speak, he decided to stay with him, and stay with him means to give some time and communicate with him. Okay. This video is going to be super short. Okay, because I have to just mention the answers and explain a little bit. Now, question number 6. How did the narrator? Sorry, question number 7. How did Roger feel at Achilles' funeral? Support your answer with examples from the story. Okay, this is something that you should write on your own, but I have provided the answer and I have shared my views. Okay, if you have anything to add, as I always say, don't hesitate to tell me, to share with me in the live class only. Okay, because if we discuss things in the live class, everyone will be, you know, the discussion will be rich and we will come to know a lot of things if you share your opinions. This is a thought-based question, I must say. Okay, so about this I would like to know from you in the live class. Roger kept on wagging his tail throughout the funeral service that was held for Achilles despite the narrator's protests. Generally, dogs wag their tails when they are happy. At least my experience says so. So this wagging of tail, it can mean that, you know, Roger was happy that his rival was gone, that his rival Achilles was dead. But at the same time, you know, you never know what an animal is trying to show or is feeling. We just can guess these things. Okay, we are not experts, obviously. We follow the theories provided by experts, and from that thing we just, at least I know that they wag their tail, as I mentioned, when they are happy. But maybe at the same time it may indicate that he was missing his he was missing Achilles. Okay, it can also happen. You just share your own thoughts if you have something else in your mind. Okay. Now, question number 8. Do you think the narrator was an animal lover? Give a reason for your answer. So here they have asked you to give a particular reason, a single reason, but I found quite a few reasons from my brain and from you also. I have mentioned all those things. Even after going through this answer, if you have something else to add, obviously let me know, definitely let me know in the live class. Okay. Yes, the narrator was, and I have not mentioned a particular point, a single point. I have mentioned some points, and if the question asks you to mention one point only, you have to choose the major one, the most important one. Okay, that is very important. Yes, the narrator was certainly an animal lover. It is indicated by his fascination with the rose beetle man and his pet animals and insects. Besides, there are some other facts that prove this. Firstly, the narrator named the stranger as Rose Beetle Man, as this man's pet beetles caught his attention the most among all other physical features and what have I mentioned? Characteristics. Okay, he could have named the man like a stranger or could not have named anything. Okay, the stranger he could have named, but he chose the name Rose Beetle Man. That was the most important thing related to him according to our author. Okay. Besides, he had a dog at home, Roger, and also got a tortoise. Later, when Achilles died, he bought a pigeon, Quasimodo, from the Rose Beetle Man. The narrator's love for animals is evident in his fond narration of animal behavior. The way he has described the behavior, the attitude, the eating style and everything about the tortoise, those things are also important. And also from the fact that search parties were immediately organized when Achilles was lost. See, the last line, I think everyone should do that. Okay, everyone should do this. This is a thing that we should do, but generally people do not do this. That is why this has become extraordinary. This is actually a common thing that everyone should do, but it is not the reality. That's why mentioning this particular thing, that when an animal, a pet animal is lost, search parties was lost, the Achilles was lost, the search parties were immediately organized. Because it was, he was equally important, just like a family member. That is why this point is important. This shows the author's love as well as the family members' love for Achilles. Okay, so any other point, and the fill in the blanks provided in quick answers portion. I have not provided the answers because you can easily do those. Easily do those. Even after going through the text very minutely, if you face any problem to solve those questions, do let me know in the revision classes. Okay, I will answer there, but only after going through the whole text very minutely and thoroughly. But I don't think you are going to have any query regarding those questions if you go through the text properly. Okay, so we will meet in the live class. Bye bye.